What is up, everybody? It's CJ Plays here, and I'm back with another Sims 3 World Overview, and today we're going to be looking at Costa Alegre. I think that's how it's pronounced. I could be wrong. Sorry if I mispronounce it. But I saw this world over on the exchange. It is by Gabby Me Love, and as y'all can see, it's like a tropical world, and I just really want to see what's here, because as you can see, it's not super big, but it looks like it's really well made, at least from the map mode and what I've seen so far. So I was like, I really need to just see what this world has to offer. Now, this world uses every single expansion pack, and it uses two stuff packs, those being Katy Perry Sweet Treats and Town Life Stuff. Also, this world does use a little bit of store content, especially those outdoor showers that come with Sunlit Tides. So you're going to probably need Sunlit Tides as well. You're going to also need Barnacle Bay because it uses some of the objects from that world as well. So I think that's everything that you might need. Now, before we get into it, some of the lots in the world are not in English, so I may not be able to pronounce everything today. So just for the sake of the video, I think I'll just call the lots what they appear to be. So for example, this is like a dock. Over here looks like a beach. So we'll kind of just go like that for the video. Also, if you were wondering why Elliot has so many people that lives with him, he could not afford to live on a single house. So he had to like rent this lot, and it comes with like a bunch of roommates. So this world is populated, by the way. Let's just go ahead and get into it. I think I want to start down here at the beach. This is the Playa Palmeras. Hopefully I said that right. So let's just go ahead and check this out. So we're down here at the beach. The first thing that I'm noticing is like all these little buildings right here. I kind of just want to open them up to see what's on the inside. So I guess we could start over here. So this one just has some all-in-one bathrooms. This one over here appears to just have a couple of lounge chairs. This one also has some more lounge chairs as well. This one has a lifeguard stand, so that's kind of useful. And then over here, you kind of have like the same thing, just some places to lounge. And then over here, ooh, okay, we have like a grill. There's a table, and then you have like a little coffee table over here as well. So I guess you can just kind of come here to chill out on the beach if you want to. This world kind of gives off like resort vibes, you know, like a nice little like tropical getaway type of thing. Okay, so why don't we just go ahead and go right beside it? So this appears to be like a port. I just want to see what's here. Okay, so I don't really see much. There is a park bench, and then you have like an area where you could dock a houseboat if you want to. And there's also like another park bench over here, but there's not really too much going on at this lot. So why don't we go ahead and move over here? This is the Parque Morez de Poseidon. Hopefully I said that right. Okay, y'all, so we're down here at the park, and like I said, this world is populated, so there are some Sims out here. If you were wondering, they just appear to be kind of vibing out here. But I do see a water fountain right here, and there's also like some places to sit around it. It looks like maybe it's going under construction, because I see like some traffic cones and stuff like that out here. There's like some more over here as well. Over here, I see a grill, and then there's a couple like wildflowers out here. There's another grill over here as well, and I'm assuming that maybe this is where the bathrooms are. Yeah, so you have your all-in-one bathrooms, your sinks, and you also have some wall speakers in here too. But I think that might just be it for this park. I don't really see anything else out here. All right, so why don't we just go right behind it? So we'll go over here first. This is the Spa and Libriera Sweet Coconut. So maybe this is like a little spa section. I guess we'll just see what this is. Okay, so I see the Weatherstone. I also see a park bench out here. And then over here, we have like a little playground section. So there's a lot of stuff from Town Life Stuff, like I was saying. So that's like a stuff pack that you'll need. So I see like a little playground section, and I don't really see anything else over here. Okay, so why don't we go over this way next? So over here is like another park. You just have like some places to sit, and it kind of looks like a big open area. So I guess if you wanted to, you could add some stuff, or I guess just come out here to chill and hang out and stuff like that. What about behind it? What's back this way? So back here, I just see like some park benches and a fountain. Maybe this is just supposed to be empty on purpose or something like that. I do see some terrain paint. So maybe down here you can like grow a garden if you want to. And then what about right beside it? And what about the one that's right beside it? So over here, I just see some more park benches. So maybe these are just like parks you could just kind of go to and add more stuff if you want to. I would wonder if maybe one of these parks has like the seasonal festivals here. Maybe that could be the case. Maybe that's why it's kind of blank right now. I would love to see if maybe like over time this actually has like seasonal stuff from seasons or something, but I'm not really for sure. Why don't we go over here next? This appears to be a fishing spot, so let's see what this is. Okay, so we're down here at the fishing spot. If I press play for a second, you'll see that there's some water going down the rocks, and I also see a little place to sit over here, but I don't really see anything else. I guess it is just like a fishing spot. You could come here to fish if you want to. I wonder if you could probably go over here if you want to and probably fish as well. I don't know if there's anything above it. Oh, you can actually live over here if you want to. That's kind of cool. Imagine like living on this little island and you can like come down here and fish if you want to, or go over to the main world. That's kind of nice. So why don't we go back this way? So we have a gym and then we also have a pool that's right beside it. So why don't we check out the gym first? Okay, so we're down here at the gym and I don't know why this happens, but I've noticed this happens sometimes in custom worlds where like the windows will be all centered and moved over. I don't know if this was intentional or not, but if I were you and I was playing in this world, I would probably like fix the windows over here. That way your Sims can actually use the pull-up bars. I don't know what causes this, but you might want to fix that. I don't know like what was going on. I've just seen this happen sometimes in custom worlds and I don't really know what causes it. All right, so when you come in though, you have a pretty big TV, actually two big TVs. There's also a couple of treadmills in here. You have a couple of wall speakers. There's a lot of Sims that live in this world. And then like over here, we have some all-in-one bathrooms. And then we have a couple of mirrors, but that's pretty much like it for the first floor. Of course, we do have our pull-up bars outside. So there is like an upstairs portion of this building, but I don't know how you would actually get up here. You might want to put some stairs or something, or maybe like a ladder. Not unless it's supposed to be just like decorative or something. I'm not really for sure. But if you can get up here some way, there's some weight machines. You have a little sweet treat register. There's a table out here, a vending machine. And then outside of the lot, you have a soccer goal. So that's kind of useful. So you do have a lot of workout equipment on this lot. Right beside it, we have the community pool lot. But for whatever reason, I got this big fountain in the way. I don't know why it's here. I'm just going to delete it really quick just so we can see the pool. I feel like that showed up because maybe I don't have the fountain that you need, like the store content. But either way, down here though, we do have a little fountain. We also have a poolside bar. We have a pool waterfall. There's also a couple places to lounge out here. You have a little sweet register over here where you can get like cakes and stuff like that. There's a pool slide out here as well, a picnic table and grill. And then over here, we have this building. I think this is just where the bathrooms are. Yeah, so you just have your all-in-one bathrooms. You have a vending machine out here as well. But I think that's like everything for this lot. Again, if you have the same issues that I do when you play in it, you could always just delete that fountain. I think that just shows up if you don't have like the store content piece or whatever. So yeah, you might want to like delete that other one. Otherwise, you can't really use the water or anything like that. Okay, so let's go ahead and go over here next. So this looks like a dance club. It's called Sims on the Beach Club. So it looks like a couple Sims are already here. So why don't we just check this out? There are like a lot of Sims that live in this world. A whole lot. Okay, well, we're down here at the Sims on the Beach Club. So I'm guessing it's supposed to be like a club or a dance club. Why don't we just open it up to see what's on the inside? Okay, so when you come in, you have like a little sweet treat register. There's a table. You have some places to sit. There's a wall speaker and a lot of different effect lights in here. And then there's something down below. Ooh, this is kind of nice. So down here, we have a photo booth. There's a bar, a little aquarium display, a lot of different effect lights in here. You have a bubble blowing machine, your bathroom's over here on this side. And then there's even something down below. So all the way down here, you have a DJ booth, you have two dance floors, a lot of different effect lights, like I said. And then over here, we have like, I guess just like some places to sit down, you know, there's a stereo, another like aquarium display. There's a couple TVs down here too. And you have some more wall speakers and lights and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff to do on this one lot. I guess that's probably why everyone is here, because it's like the hangout spot. And then even outside of the lot, there's a bar. You have a bubble blowing machine here and here. And I think that might just be it. But I'm telling y'all, these Sims here are getting lit, like legit. Okay, so why don't we go ahead and move over this way? So we have an alchemy shop, and then we also have a graveyard to check out. So let's check out the alchemy shop first. Ooh, I really like this lot. It looks like something that you would see in Isla Paradiso. It's so nice though, and I like the color of the roof too. Ooh, and I like the inside too. I love the color scheme. So when you come in, you have your lunar horoscope item. You have an alchemy station. Over here, of course, you have your, you know, elixir register and stuff like that. There's a broom rack over here as well. And then you have a lot of different assorted items, as you can see. So there's a lot of stuff in here. Outside of the lot, we have our beekeeping boxes. And then let's go ahead and go upstairs. So upstairs, we have a llama teleporter box. We have a gym cutting machine. And then we also have like a consignment register. So I guess it's like a 2-in-1 type of lot. And then there's also a fireplace. And I think that might just be it for the inside. Outside, oh, I didn't even see this, but there's even like a little rocking chair out here and like a little place to sit. There's a little fairy house. So there's quite a lot on this one little lot. So this is kind of cool. All right, let's go right next door to it though. So this is the graveyard. Ooh, I like all the trees around it. So you have your mausoleum over here, and then you also have a couple of graves. I think these might just all be decorative graves. I don't think they have any names on them, but you do have like some graves out here, some places to sit. You have a Grim Reaper statue, and then you have like more places to sit. So it's not a super big graveyard, but it's kind of cute. I like all the trees and landscaping around it though. Okay, so I think that was the last community lot in the world. So now we can check out the residentials. I guess I'll start off by showing y'all where I placed Elliot down at. So like I said earlier, he could not afford to live on like a single lot by himself. So I had to move him here. And I guess this is listed as like an apartment. So he lives here with a bunch of roommates. So why don't we just check out the house? I guess we'll start in the middle. So when you come in, you have a bedroom area over here with an all-in-one bathroom. You have a kitchen, your table, and then out here on the deck space, you have a grill. And then moving on over this way, we have like another room. So maybe they're like separate apartments, or maybe that's what they're supposed to be. Because like over here, you have a kitchen, you have a bedroom, a bathroom, a little place to sit. Over here, we have like a little lounge space. And then let's go back this way. So over here, it's kind of like the same thing, you know, it's like a kitchen, bedroom, bathroom. And then you have like lounge space out here as well. Why don't we try to go upstairs real quick? So when you go upstairs, this looks like an empty room. I guess you can add something if you want to. And let's try to go upstairs again. So I guess it's just empty up here. So I guess it's just like empty space at the top. Okay, so why don't we check out this house that's right beside it? I don't think that anybody lives at this one. So on the inside, we have an all-in-one bathroom. We have a bedroom over here with a crib. And then we also have a kitchen. You know what? So is this like a starter home? I would imagine it was, but for whatever reason, Elliot could not move here. So maybe it's like technically not a starter home for one sim. Now you might want to put a chair over here so your sim can actually eat at the desk. But other than that though, you do have a house over here. And I think there's also a house across the street from it, but I think this one is occupied. Yeah, we have some sims that live at this one. So we have this sim over here. Who is this? This is Gabriella. Okay, so Gabriella lives over here. Why don't we go ahead and open up the house real quick? So when you first come in, you have your kitchen area over here. There's a nice pool out here as well. You have some places to lounge. I feel like I'm missing some content because I feel like that should not be there. So maybe I'm missing something. But over here though, you have a bathroom. And then outside, you have like a little place where you can sit at the umbrella table. And I wonder if there's like an upstairs. There is, but there's no way to get up here. So you might want to put like a stair or a ladder. Maybe I'm missing something. I don't think I am, but yeah, I don't know how your son would get up here though. But either way, there is a bed and a crib. I would say maybe put a ladder like right here, like maybe delete this and put a ladder or something. Because I don't know how your Sims would get up here. So yeah, I would say definitely get a ladder for this house. Okay, so there are some other houses over here that we haven't seen. So let's start maybe over here at this one first. Y'all look, it's the same thing that's going on with this house. I don't know what's causing this, but what I would do is probably just go into buy mode and maybe just like move everything over. You might have to use move objects or something, but like move the windows over because like I don't know what's causing them to shift over. Like I said, I've seen this happen before in other custom worlds, so it could just be a Sims 3 thing, but yeah, that's definitely something that I noticed though. But let's go ahead and just check out the house. Okay, so when you come in, you have your kitchen area, there's a living room area with a fireplace. There is a bathroom down here. You have a swimming pool over here in the back with a couple of lounge chairs. And then when you go upstairs, you have a bedroom here with a crib. You have another bedroom over here with a TV and desk. And then you also have like a dresser in the hallway. And then when you go upstairs, again, it takes you to the top of the lot. So there's a table, a fire pit, and a little place to sit. But I think that's like everything for this house. So why don't we check out the one that's right beside it? Again, I don't know. Maybe this is supposed to be intentional. Maybe it's supposed to look interesting. I don't know. But the windows on this house is kind of like all over the place. So I don't know. Maybe it's supposed to be like that. I don't know. But let's just open up the lot. So inside of here, though, we have a kitchen. Oh, I like the inside of here. You have a kitchen. You have like some places to sit. Yeah, see, I feel like that's supposed to be intentional because it has like the windows around it. I don't know. But outside of the house, there's a place to sit over here. There's a table, an all-in-one bathroom. And then you have like a pool back here with some lounge chairs. And then when you go upstairs again, you have a bedroom with a crib. There's a TV. And then you have your bathroom over here in the corner. And then there's even like a balcony out here with a grill and a place to lounge. So I think that's like everything for this house. All right, let's check out the house that's right beside it. I love the color scheme. Let's go ahead and open up this one really quick. So when you first come in, over here you have your kitchen. You also have a desk over here with a bookshelf. Outside of the house, we have a pool area with a grill, a pool waterfall, and some places to lounge. This house is actually kind of nice. And then when you go upstairs, you have a bedroom here. There's a crib in the hallway. You have your bathroom, another bedroom, maybe for like kids or teens. And then there's even like some more stairs. So when you go upstairs yet again, there's another bedroom. You have another crib in the hallway. Oh, and this bedroom has an ensuite bathroom. Okay, I see. So this house has like a lot of space. Oh, and there's also like this other house that's right beside it. I didn't even see this one. Ooh, this one's like on stilts. This one looks kind of cool. So you go up these steps. So when you enter into the house, you have like a kitchen area down here. And then when you go upstairs, you have a bed, a crib, and a bathroom. And then there's also like a little balcony. Now, is this house populated or is this one like an unpopulated? Yeah, so nobody lives at this house. So maybe this is supposed to be like a starter type of house where you can kind of just move in and add more stuff if you want to. Oh, there's also this house over here that we didn't see. This one is over here by like where Elliot lives at. Oh, this one is nice too. I like the color of the roof. Oh, this one is actually nice. I love like the living room over here. The furnishing is really cute. It kind of looks like super fancy too. But when you come in though, you have an aquarium display. So over here, we have like a little den area with a bookshelf. Going over this way, we have our kitchen. And then there's also like some stairs to go up. So let's go upstairs real quick. Ooh, this bed is interesting. So when you come upstairs though, you have a bedroom over here. This pattern is custom content. I don't know how it's showing up. I don't think this world uses any custom content. So maybe I'm missing something. But up here though, you have a bed with a little chair. It even has like a balcony. And then over here, we have like another bedroom. This over here is a bathroom. And then you have like a couple cribs in the hallway. And then like outside of the house, there's like another bed out here. You have some places to lounge. There's a pool waterfall, and springboard. And then, oh, I didn't even see this. So out here, like down below, you have a couch, some tables. There's some places to lounge out here, a speedboat. There's a fire pit. There's like a lot of stuff. There's even like a buffet table out here too. So I feel like this is a house, but I feel like it's probably more so for like parties and stuff like that. Maybe like a party house, or the Sims that live here like to entertain other Sims. I didn't even see this, but there's also like a grill over here too. So there's like a lot over here at this house, y'all. Before we go, I want to go into edit town mode just to see if there's any additional empty lots in the world or not. Okay, so there doesn't really appear to be, other than like this house over here. Like I said earlier, you can have a Sim live over here if you want, and they can like, you know, you could just build a house or place one down. It's not a super big lot, but you could live here if you want to. But I think that's like the only empty lot in the world, unless you like, you know, delete other houses and stuff like that. But I think that's pretty much everything for this world, y'all. Again, this world is called Costa Alghieri. Hopefully I pronounced that right. This world is by Gabby Me Love. I like this world, but I feel like you have to do a little bit of work to kind of get things to function properly, like with the windows and like how some of the houses and lots don't really have ladders. So that's something that I noticed. It might not be a big deal for you. So if you want to get this world and check it out, I'll leave it linked down below. But I would say if you want to live in this world, playing this world, maybe like change up some of the windows and stuff and make sure that some of the lots are functional. Otherwise, your Sims are going to get stuck. But anyway, y'all, that is all that I have for this video. If you did enjoy it, please be sure to leave a like, comment something down below. Follow me over on Twitch where I stream a lot more of The Sims, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Thanks for watching.